So my name is Heardley Moses Murdock, and we are in the Laboratory of Host Defenses at the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Disease. So we work on a disease called DOCK-8 Deficiency, which is a genetic disease that causes susceptibility to infections, particularly skin infections. Some of them eventually get cancers, really bad allergies, food allergies, and other types of allergies. And we're trying to understand what exactly is wrong with the immune system, the part of our body that fights off infection in these patients. So I'm originally from Florida, and my family's from Central America, so they moved here right before I was born. And all throughout middle school and high school, I had teachers who were really passionate about science, who really helped me in my journey. I took science classes, and my professors took time out of their own day to show me the microscope and show me how exciting it is to look at the cells and the human body. And later on in college, I also had amazing professors who allowed me to work in their lab. And eventually, I got really interested in medicine, but also really interested in science and trying to find a way to mix these two long term. And so I came here to the NIH to do exactly that. It gets me excited. Well, this lab actually discovered the disease, and we're now trying to figure out more about what is it about these cells that are in our skin and in our bodies that's wrong with them. And so we're making videos of these cells and trying to study them in the lab to see if we can explain why these people have the infections that they do. This lab is really interesting and unique, I think, because we are able to study human cells. And so I really like the fact that I can look at cells from normal people and look at them under the microscope, look at them here at the proteins that are inside of them, pipetting things, that sort of work. I have a mentor that really helps me along. We have patients from around the world that come here, from everywhere, from Turkey to various places in the Americas. And so you really get to see a wide range of both patients, but also people who are working on the problem.
Because I already tested all three of the siRNAs and they all work. So if I send him just one or two vials?
Yeah, maybe you can talk to him first.
I'll call him later on today.
Yeah.
It would be amazing if we could take what we learn about why the disease is happening and find a way to treat these patients. Currently, it's transplants, and most of the patients that get transplants do really well, but if we can find a less invasive way to do it or a more targeted way to do it, that would be fantastic. And also just to understand, in healthy people, how do we, you, me, and everybody around us, deal with these microbes that are in the environment? I think more and more we'll be understanding, both in this disease and other genetic diseases, how our immune system works, and hopefully ways to prevent the infections that are not unique to this particular patient population, but in all people. Find someone older than you who is willing to take you under their wing and be comfortable with failure. It's really hard when something doesn't work out, but moving through that and having someone to support you as you move through that can take you really far.